बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक इन लेक्चर लेक्चर नंबर 10। सॉरी, इन लेक्चर नंबर 10 वी विल डिस्कस द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द लेक्चर नंबर 9, बिकॉज वी डोंट कंप्लीट दैट लेक्चर। बेसिकली वी स्टार्ट द फ्लेक्चर डिजाइन ऑफ द बीम, एंड बिफोर आई डिस्कस आई ऑलरेडी शेयर दिस वीडियो, एंड हेयर यू सी द फ्लेक्चर फेलियर ऑफ ए बीम। And it is very critical, remember that you have to properly design, flexurely properly design the beam, okay? If you not properly design, you not properly detail the structure, remember this kind of problems you will see in this side, because this is my one of my practical problems which I am observing and I am working on it, okay? So I am investigating things, okay, these cracks you see here, and I will share the detailed design of these kind of design inshallah in the last of the of this lecture or these lectures, okay? So you see, I will also share this video. These are the flexure cracks which you will see here, and okay, these are the flexure cracks, and remember we start this design, okay? We reaches, we calculate the loading, and we do basically the flexure design. We find out the area of steel and 3 number add bar, and remember we are in depth D, we are calculating D. So here you see that this is my effective clear depth, okay, clear cover, and here I am basically including basically the stirrup. So this clear spacing is how much is 2 inches now, and I add this half spacing, that is number 8, and number 8 half will be 8 divided by if you divide it by 8, it gives you the dia, and if you have to half the dia by 2, so that's why 8 by 16, okay? Remember, when you divide number of bar divide by 8, it will give you diameter of the bar, okay? And 2 is due to half the dia bar, okay? So 2 is that clear spacing, and D by 16, it give me that amount of spacing, okay? So at initial stage, basically we are assuming that we are using 15 inch, but now we know that we are using number air, so that why 15.5 inch. So therefore when if I am using 3 number air bar, it give me AS this much. Now I have to check the moment capacity, whether this amount of steel will work for this moment. So when I plug the values, I got the answer 1920, and which is more than MU. So this means 3 number add bar will work, okay? So I have to provide 3 number add bar in my beam, but here you see cut up bars, okay? And you all know about cut up bars, and if you don't know the cut up bars, please watch this these lectures, okay? Especially this lecture number 12, available on my YouTube channel. Go to my playlist and PRC1, PRC2, okay? Here you understand what is theoretical cutoff point, what is actual cutoff point, okay? In very deep detail, okay? So, here I am using basically cutoff bars. Cutoff, okay? Let me show you a diagram. Okay, let's say I have a beam. Okay, that beam I have, let me draw it. Okay, let me draw it clearly. Let us, okay, this is the diagram, and let me select the bars, okay? So I have, let us choose this one, clear? I have bars right here, okay, and I discontinued bar, 1 bar, okay? If I cut the bar, this is okay. Now how much percentage of steel I am discontinued, okay? This is important, this one is important, okay? So here you see in this example, right, in this example, okay, that I am cutting 1 number add bar. So 1 number add bar means how much percentage of bar I am discontinued, okay? So if you are interested to find out this percentage, the area of number 8 bar is 0.785, So divided that by 2.35, because 2.35 is my maximum reinforcement. Okay, so that is my maximum reinforcement. So we find out the ratio and multiply by 133% bar I am cutting. Now why I need this 33%? Because I have to use graph. Okay, so if you want to become the master of using these graphs, again I am suggesting you to please watch these videos. Here you see I thoroughly explain these graphs for continuous beams, for simply supported beam, because this graph which I am using here is only used for a simply supported beam, not for a continuous beam, remember. And here I am not using L by 3 L by 4. So where it is the graph, this is the graph, remember. This is available, these graphs are available in the last pages of Nielsen book, and location for simply supported beam, remember, not for continuous and other type of beams. Here you see the percentages which you are cutting down, and here you see the decimal or differential distances which we give you, that how at what distance you will cut that percentage of steel. So as you see, I am cutting 33%. So right here I just drag a line here, and then I go down, and here I have this point, nearly this point. So 0.2 means 0.3. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 digits. This is round about 0.21. Okay, round about. So that why here you see, I am using 0.21. So multiply this 0.21 with the spacing, that is the clear spacing of the beam. Okay, here you see 18 point. This will give you the theoretical cutoff point location. Now what is theoretical cutoff point and what is actual cutoff point? Again, you have to watch these videos, because that is another discussion. If I start explaining those theoretical and cutoff points, so this is in another discussion. Okay, and you see 1 hour and more videos, times of watch, you can say video available on theoretical and actual cutoff points. So what is theoretical point? What is actual cutoff points? And you see here again how we calculate it. So please watch that videos. Okay. And I don't want to waste time here. Okay, now remember that from the face of the bar, now I have to cut the bar at a distance of how much? 3.96 feet. 3.96 feet. This is not L by 3 or L by 4. This is actual. Now we are using graphs. Okay, 3.96, but remember this graph gave me the theoretical cutoff point. Okay, this is theoretical cutoff point. I have to extend this for a distance of how much? For a distance of 12 dB. Okay, for a distance of 12 dB, or it equals to D. Okay, which one is greater? You find out 12 dB. How you can calculate 12 dB? 12 times dB, that is 8 divided by 8. Here I am using 8, number 8 bar. So you got 12. And as your D value is 15.5 inch, so that why 15.5 is governed. 15.5 is governed. So here we are adding that 15.5 with the theoretical cutoff point, that is 3.96. 3.96 plus 15.5, clear, divide by 12. You got the actual cutoff point location. Actual cutoff point location. And here I am find out the basically if you are finding the theoretical cutoff point from the midpoint, then you have to add up in this direction. If you are providing the theoretical cutoff point from this direction, then you have to do calculation in the reverse direction. Here I am wrong. Okay, sorry for that mistake. Here I am wrong. Okay, let me rub it. Clear. Remember, if you are providing the theoretical cutoff point location from the mid, then you have to extend this for a distance of 12 dB or 16. Now that theoretical cutoff point, basically which I am calculating here, this is 3.96 from this end. Now I have to reverse this in this direction. Remember, in this direction, this is actually 12 dB or 16 12 dB are equals to D. Okay, so I have to subtract. Basically this is subtraction, this is not addition. sorry for this. Okay, this is subtraction. Okay, so you have to subtract because you are increasing the development length. Remember, this is very important discussion. Remember, it is very, very important discussion. For example, this is your critical location. The bar should extend for a distance of LD, development length, and I have recorded that 18 videos only on development length, and the bar should extend up to a distance of LD. Remember, it must extend for a distance of LD and must extend for a distance of LD. Now, this is basically your theoretical cutoff point. Okay, this is your actual, and then you have to obtain your actual cutoff point. So if you want to guard the actual cutoff point, you have to add this 12 dB with R dB with that theoretical cutoff point. So you got this actual cutoff point. Okay, this actual cutoff point. If you are using the graph, so the graph will give you the distance of theoretical cutoff point from the face from the end of the beam. Now you have, as you are decreasing your development, you are moving in this direction. So that why you have to subtract this distance, that is 12 dB or D. So now here is your actual cutoff point. Okay, again, this is the way that how we can reverse the calculation. Okay, so this is very important, and these videos, basically these 18 videos, all are related to this cutoff points videos, and this is very, very important videos for detailing purpose. Okay, it will, you can say it will enhance your understanding regarding your detailing. Okay, so this winds up the flexure design of the beam. Now the shear design, it is simple, and I think this is not so tricky, because the simply supported beam shear force diagram is simple. This is maximum shear, and we have to find a distance of D, and D is 15.5 inches. This is total length. You find out this distance X by similar triangular rules. You find out the capacity of shear capacity, and again, that is 20 kip. Vs is nothing, Vu minus pi Vc divided by V value. You all know this, 5.9 kip. So this is very small amount of shear. Okay, so again, I'm using AV SAM number 4 bar and S D by 2 and this one, because my V is, if you calculate your Vs, basically, for example, your V value, that is 4 phi into under root FC prime into BD. So this Vs will be less than this value. So that why I'm using these equations. Clear? If this is more than that one, so then this value will be D by 4 and this one will be 12 inches. Remember. And my final S is 7.75. Provide number 4 at the rate of 7 inch center to center. If I providing this amount of shear reinforcement, then what will be my basically my spacing? If I calculate, this is the actual spacing, remember, and you know, 63 inches. So we don't need 63 because we have to use these limit values and the minimum one. Okay, this is the check, just only check. Okay, for example, I am checking that if I am using 7.75 inches, so how much shear capacity will be? So bring this S here and Vs there, you see the capacity of your structure of your beam. Okay, so it will be, you can say, too larger. Okay, so basically we provide nominal shear reinforcement. Okay, as we did in first example. Okay, so this winds up the whole calculation. Okay, and if you have any question regarding these lectures up to this point, you can ask your questions. And the final detailing, you need to show the detailing. Okay, for, as I did, show the detailing for a continuous beam, that is B1. Now for B2, the same way of doing showing calculations. If I show you, for example, let me show you the calculation. The calculation is simple. Okay, you just need to draw the beam. Okay, you just need to draw the beam. You just need to show this one. Okay, and one bar is cut up. Okay, and this distance is basically calculated. Okay, this distance is basically calculated, that is 3.95 minus that 15.5. okay, and you got that link. And similarly, you have to provide two number six bar, let's say, or you find your AS minimum for this beam, and provide that AS minimum for as a supporting bar, okay? And then use the shear reinforcement as we got 7.7 inches center to center, number four at the rate of 7 inches center to center. This is the detaining of that beam, clear? I think so, it is not difficult. And remember, watch these videos, because all these videos you see here relating with the detailing of the beam, okay, and the cutup points, actual cutup points, and there are continuous beams, simply supported beams, overhang beams. I saw so many examples from Nelson, McCormick, McGregor books, and as well as I defined the codes limitations. So very informative lectures these are, and thank you for watching. If you have any question, any suggestions, please share your suggestions